Hello everybody, welcome back to the Metal Scrapper channel. So the person who donated these cables to me also had a problem with it's a kind of rake to wool the earth or shake the earth a little bit loose, but it's broke down. So yeah, I want to return a favor and try to weld this. I am doing some TIG welding or GTAW welding for the US people. This will be my first real job. I did some practicing a while back ago. And yeah, let's do this step by step. First thing, I will grind this flat, and this is the piece that has been broken off. Come on, get in focus. We'll also make sure the pieces where I will weld are clean. Always make sure that the metals you are welding are clean. So I will grind this a little bit, grind this flat, and I think I will first attach it without adding any metals. Just heat it up with my GTAW torch and get it a little bit fixed, and then I'll try to fill it up with some added metals. So let's do this. So the first step will be grinding this a little bit flat, so I have a flat surface to work on. We'll also grind this piece flat and clean the stuff where I will melt the metal. Got a grinding disc on the angle grinder, and as always, make sure to work safe. Got some hearing protection and some eye protection, and we'll also wear some gloves. Alright, so this looks pretty decent. I'm not sure if I will remove the paint. Maybe it's better if I do, because I will weld a little bit of this stuff, make it liquid again, and get in stuff here. So the next step will be getting this flat and clean the metal rod. So we also made this flat. One thing I'm thinking about is the diameter. You can see my, it's a finger with a glove, but it's pretty wide. It's almost 1 centimeter or maybe 1/3 of an inch, something like that. I'm not sure if I'm going to make an angle on this. Let me think about this for a moment. And why do I want to have an angle on this? To make this a little bit smaller, so I can fill it up with my added metal. So we have one solid piece, and not only the outside has been welded, and the inner side will not be welded. So I think I will get the grinder and grind this with an angle. Alright, so I got the grinder, and I think I'll make a little bit an edge. Yeah, you will see what I mean if I'm done. Alright, so we're getting a little bit of an angle here. Come on. So I want it to have a little bit thinner, so I can also melt the inner side. We're almost there. Alright, I'm happy with this. Okay, so the next step, like I said, will be grinding all the old metal away, so we have clean metal for the melt. Well, not only for the melt, for the weld. Alright, to clean the metal, I won't use a grinder, we'll use a flap disc. This has less impact on the metal, otherwise I will grind a lot of metal away. Okay, so we have a clean surface to work with. So let's get the welding device. I'll tack this to the rake, and then let's start some welding. So I got my welding machine. This is the cable which will go with the clamp to the piece I will be working with. So we have a full circuit. This of course is the torch, and with the tungsten electrode, have it approximately at an angle of 60 degrees or something, 2 times 30 degrees. It has a hard time focusing. So I got my inactive gas, it's argon, so I'll get the machine running, got my welding gloves, and of course I need my welding helmet, not some safety goggles. Alright, have my welding helmet, and it's a little bit different than I'm used from the welding school. I have that 13, so that's the darkest shade I can get. The TIG flame can get pretty light, so yeah, just tested the battery. I'll put this on and let's tack the missing part to the rake. I have it at around, well, get you closer. I get it at 2 tack, so I have that about 70 amps. It should be enough to get a tack on it. And then, yeah, when it's solid attached, I can start the welding and add some metal. And what I just did here is I went from 4 tacked to 2 tacked. So when I press the button, it will weld, but if I release the button, it will stop welding. If I have the 4 tacked, if I press the button, it will start weld, and I have to can release the button and it stays welding. If I touch the button again, it will stop welding. But to have it under control, I will have that 2 tacked. Alright, now let's get our fingers crossed and hope this will succeed. I'll have my clamp on a piece that has bare metal. This will should do the job. Get my welding gloves on, and I hope I can tack it. Really curious. It will be the first time in several months, and never did a project like this. So we'll see. Alright, so I first want to have a tacked it onto this. I have no clamps or something, so just have to do it on eyesight. We'll see. That didn't do it a lot. I think I have to increase my my amp. You can see I did a little bit. I don't know if it's in focus because I cannot see what I'm filming, but it did a little bit, but not much. So I'll increase the amps. It's a pretty thick piece of metal. Just try it again. Alright, so we have one small tack. Let's see if it's in line. Nope. Looking a little bit better, I guess. It's looking better and better. I'll have it flipped over. Now let's get this back in the shot. Oops, I forgot to put on the clamp. It was a... Yep, we have welded the clamp. That was pretty stupid. So do not forget to put on the clamp. Otherwise you'll be welding other stuff. Alright, here we go again. So this should be tacked enough. Have it at the same angle as the other one, I guess. Almost. It's all a little bit on my side, but I'll get you closer. Sorry, somehow the phone stopped recording. I just did one piece welding. It's not really beautiful, but I hope that this will be effective. The working conditions are far from ideal. I'm not able to see what I'm filming. And yeah, really need to more working space. Alright, I want to have this. I think this is in the screen right now, I hope. This is the life of a welder, I guess. Always wait a couple of seconds before removing the nozzle, because we have a post flow time of the argon gas, which will protect the weld spot. Okay, we have a harder to reach area here. I hope I can reach this properly. That's a real hard spot to reach. Man, it's still not filled correctly. Damn. Let's see if I can put it in like here. I think this is it. It's not pretty. It's really shitty. But I think this will do the job. Man, this is very ugly. So let's see what we have done. It's not as pretty as this one, but hey, it's your first time. Man, this is really ugly. This should do the job, I guess. Try to fill it up as good as possible. And yeah, not really happy with this spot yet. So I'll give another go for that spot. It's a little bit hollow there. So we'll fill it up with some metal again. Right, so still want to fill up this piece here. It's not a real big deal, but again, from a better angle, just don't like that crater over there. So yeah, let's fill it up. Don't want the rake to be demolished after the first time of use. Right, so bear with me. Here we go. Clamps on. Yep. I think that will be better. It doesn't look really, really beautiful, but let's say it's functional. I'll give it a final inspection, and I think we're good to go. So here it is. I gave it a little stress test. Hope this will stay on. And again, it's not a beautiful job, not at all, but I hope this will be functional. I'll get the wire brush, get this cleaned, and give this a fresh spray of paint, and then I'll show the end results. If you guys like this video, let me know in the comments. If you just think, yes, just keep it at melting, that's also an answer. But occasionally I will do a welding video, but I hope with some better results. This was the first project I'm doing, and it's really, really ugly. Didn't really exactly know how to tackle this problem, but yeah, it was a while ago. Maybe if I'm doing it more, it will be better. But I'll give this another coat tomorrow, and then this project should be finished. But I will do that off camera, So this is the end result. Not the best weld ever, I know. But you gotta start somewhere, right? Right, this was it. Thanks a lot for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. If so, please give this video a thumbs up, leave a comment. Do not forget to subscribe and hit the bell button to see a melding video or occasionally a welding video. At least it has to do with some metals. Right, so yeah, pretty happy to do some welding again. Currently I am at school for welding, but it's not GTAW welding, but metal active gas welding, or MAG welding, we call it in Holland, MAG, with active gas. Right, so have a great week, and next week I'll be back with some melding videos again. So see you then, bye bye!